guys, this is Jason. Today's date is November 28, 2012. Guys, I'm making a video today in regards to Kesha's performance with her song entitled Die Young that she did on the Today Show a couple days ago. Now, I know I've created a couple videos already on the Satanic Occult and the Illuminati, but I wanted to break down this for you step by step so you can see with your own eyes what is taking place that most of the world is blinded to. You'll notice in this video that the parents, the moms, and the daughters, and the young kids are sitting there singing and chanting and following after Kesha, not realizing what she is doing in front of their face. But see, that's how easy Satan has deceived the world. The world is following after the occult, and they don't even realize it. That's the sad part. Just like in this picture, she has a satanic pentagram around her neck. A lot of people just don't understand. Their eyes are not open. Their spiritual eyes are blinded. Satan has even blinded most Christians this day. You can show a Christian this stuff, and they're like, what is this? They're even blinded by it. So I'm going to break down this video, and I'm going to take it step by step, and I'm going to show you how the occult has mingled itself within all the music so you can understand, you can see this for yourself. But I'm going to go in and let you watch that video now.
Her debut album went to the top of the charts, producing number one hits like TikTok and We Are Who We Are, which we just heard. And now Kesha has a new album coming out December 4th. It is called Warrior. Kesha, good morning to you.
Good morning.
So much going on. Fans were just dying to hear this second album. And I know you really took creative control of this. Was it important to you to really let your voice be heard?
Absolutely. It was really important for me on this record to sing, because I really can sing.
Because a lot of people, they've heard the auto-tune, they've heard your dance hits, but you really have a great voice, too.
Thank you. I know I got, like, bummed out when I heard that, and so I just really wanted to show people that I can sing. It's one of the few things I can do, so I wanted to do it.
After all of your success, you come back from touring, and I know the record company was saying, okay, let's get that second album, and you did something courageous. You said, I'm going to take a little time off.
Yeah, I went on a spirit journey, because I wanted to go play with animals. So I had to do that.
Well, we'll see if any of that influence came out in the new album. And I should mention, you have a new book coming out.
Yeah, it came out today, actually.
And there is a picture, which we just have to show. It's you, I think you're, 7 years old in the picture we're about to see, and you have body paint all over you. So this has been going on a long time.
Oh, I've always loved body paint. Forever. And there's a dollar sign in my name. And so, it's real.
See, it started way back then. What are you going to sing for us this morning?
I'm about to sing Die Young.
Kesha, take it away.
I love you, Kesha.
I hear your heartbeat to the beat of the drums. Oh, what a shame that you came here with someone. So while you're here in my arms, let's make the most of the night.
As you see in this segment, you'll notice that she's wearing an upside-down cross on her blouse or wardrobe here. The cult like to flip the cross upside down because it's a representation of, it's like slapping Jesus Christ in the face for dying on the cross. It's also a slap in the face to Christianity. As you'll notice in the picture after this, you'll notice that the woman is doing the horns of Baphomet, which a lot of people like to say it's the love sign for sign language. No, it's not. It's the horns of Baphomet, which is Hail Satan. But you'll also notice on the side of her head she has the upside down cross. It's a mockery to Jesus Christ. In this segment, you will notice that the three dancers that are along with Kesha, on the front of their garments, they have the goat of Baphomet, which this is the horns of Baphomet, which a lot of people like to say is the love sign for sign language, which is false. Guys, you got to understand that the horns of Baphomet came way before the sign language sign. They created the sign language sign for a cover up, because to cover up the horns of Baphomet. That's what the occult did after the 70s. Because what the love sign stands for is peace and harmony, love. That's what we're entering is the age of Aquarius, love, peace, and harmony, ruled under the Antichrist in the New World Order. When people hold up the horns of Baphomet and somebody says, oh, that's the love sign for sign language, it's a lie, guys. It's a cover-up for the horns of Baphomet. They're giving their allegiance and telling you who they worship. I don't care what people say, that's what it is. If you look on the front of these dancers' wardrobe, they have the horns of Baphomet, the star, the pentagram. They have that right there. And then you also notice on their pants leg, they have the star of Baphomet, which is the pentagram as well, on their pants. Segment, you'll notice on the Kesha's three dancers on the back of their garments, they have the all-seeing eye, which is the all-seeing eye of Horus, which is Satan, which is the same thing that's on your $1 bill on the pyramid. And I'll show you pictures of that now, which is also in my occult Illuminati videos as well. And I just wanted to show you the look on everyone's face, everyone cheering. Here's mom back here smiling, happy she's on TV. Daughter right here below her, probably her older daughter right here. And you just see the happiness in everybody's face. This looks like some good little family here. And she's got her kids sitting here watching the occult. And they're sitting there on TV happy. See, they don't realize that they're being deceived. But you can clearly see that they're having the time of their life showboating her daughter to the occult right in front of her face. But see, that's how easy the world is deceived, and they don't even know it, but they're having the time of their life. Sitting there watching somebody that's slapping Jesus Christ in the face with an upside-down cross on her garments. Wild night, like it's the last night. I just wanted to show you a better view of the upside down cross on her garment. Like we're gonna die young. In this segment, this poor little girl right here that's throwing her hands up, happy she's getting to see Kesha. This little poor little girl don't even realize that she is sitting there watching the occult right in front of her face, but yet she feels like she's getting to see some entertainment. That's how easy the world is deceived. And even the children, the teenagers, are being deceived by it. And their families and parents are letting them be deceived by it because the families and parents are deceived as well. You know, that magic in your face is making me blush. In this segment, I wanted to show you the dancers for Kesha. Now, I've already showed you the Go to Baphomet star on their chest, but also on their garments and their pants. They have the All-Seeing-Eye, which is Satan, All-Seeing-Eye of Horus. And then they also have the Go to Baphomet star, which is on their pants, which is the pentagram as well. But yet, you see in the background, all these kids are throwing their hands up. Yay, we get to see Kesha when she's got an upside-down cross on her garments right here, slapping Jesus Christ in the face, and they've got satanic pentagrams on their pants. But you got families in the background singing and clapping and happy. They're seeing this. Alright guys, I bring you a segment here. Many of you remember that Black and Yellow song from a couple years ago by Wiz Khalifa. And my kid even come in singing it sometimes and stuff. But if you look at the video and you stop it at 206, you'll notice the guy, it happens so quick so you have to catch it. But the guy in the back with the black cap jumps up and down. And he's wearing a Go to Baphomet shirt, which is the pentagram, satanic pentagram. And this kid right here, right below him, is throwing up the horns of Baphomet hand sign, which is not the I love you. It is the horns of Baphomet, meaning hell, Satan. Just like in the picture to the right, you've got Marilyn Manson, and he's got the pentagram behind this, the pentagram behind his back here, which is the same thing the guy's got on his shirt here, which is Satan. And he's also got the horns of Baphomet on his shirt, which is also hell, Satan. The same thing this kid is doing right here. But if somebody saw this video, they'd say, oh, he's doing the I love you sign. No, he's not. The I love you sign is the hell of the horns of Baphomet. It's the same thing. That's just how the cult covered it up discreetly so they could do it. And you say, oh, they're saying I love you. It's the horns of Baphomet, hell, Satan.